What is up, my awesome achievers? I'm so excited to start a new book with you today. But before we do, I thought maybe just for a second, you could just like let loose, get some good vibes flowing before we start a new book. It always helps when you're in a good mood. Get loose before the new book. Okay. Well, if you didn't dance, hopefully you at least laughed at my dancing. Just to get loose before we start our new book today. So, if you remember, in our last book, Remya's invention won a competition or a contest. Basically the same thing. So today you're going to read about another non-fiction book about a contest. It's called Construction Creations. Or creations. If you're French, you would say construction creations. But we're not, so. So people build structures with all kinds of cans. This book is the first book in a series called Making a Difference. And as we start to read about this competition, you're gonna see where that comes into play. Let's scroll down to our table of contents first in the beginning of the book. And we know that our table of contents is in the beginning of the book because it really helps us to preview what we're going to read in the entire book from beginning to end. Let's take a look here. What is our first section called? Right, our first section or chapter is called A Contest to Help People. And like I said, that Making a Difference series that this book is a part of. That's all going to start unraveling, and you're going to see how that makes a difference. So, this contest is one that is fun, but also helps people. Think about that while you're reading. How does this help people? Let's turn to page two. What does this picture look like? Yeah, it's like a baby dinosaur coming out of an egg, like, it looks hungry. It's like it's ready to gobble up some food. Can you say the word thousands for me? Thousands. Thousands. We know we can hear that first sound, the sound, and know that the TH are the letters that make that sound. Point to it right now on page three. Great job. It is the last line on page three. So each of these structures, like this dinosaur, is made up of thousands of cans of food. And this food will go to feed hungry families. Now, the name of that series is making sense now, too. So I just said each of these structures is made up of thousands of cans of food. What is a structure? I know when I think of a structure, I think of things that come to mind are buildings, houses, bridges, like the way things are built, the structure of them, the shape of them. Those are some things that come to mind. I don't know the actual definition, but knowing other things that are like that really helps me to think about what that word might mean. So this dinosaur, an example of a structure made entirely of cans of food. People build the structures to try and win this contest called the Canstruction Contest. And it's a construction, but we say can instead of construction to get a little play on words. Kind of make it funny. Let's go to page 4. Can you find the word compete on page 4? We talked about that word in the last book too. Let's see. Oh, there it is. I found it. You might see the word contest a few times, and then we're going to see the word compete. Remember that, compete. So teams build the structures, and they decide what to build, and then they have to make a plan. They think really hard about the colors, the shapes, how big it's going to be, how much it's going to weigh. It's tough. There's a lot of things that you have to think about. So let's scroll through the next few pages and just take a look at some of these structures that these teams have built. Looks like Cinderella. Good old Tommy Boy, the train engine. All right, let's skip over to page 15, 14 and 15. Get my face out of the way. So this page explains that after the contest, the structures are totally taken apart by volunteers. Can you say the word volunteers? Good. Now I want you to say it in parts, as if you were going to clap it out. Say it out loud. Good. Volunteers. Find it on the page 15. Good. Now I want you to use your finger and cover up the parts of the word just like you sounded it out in parts. Great job. So not only can we hear the different parts in the word, but we can see how the words are broken up too. So as you read, I want you to remember that the real goal of this contest is to help feed a bunch of hungry families. People have these contests in big spaces like shopping malls or in big gymnasiums. And after a few days, volunteers take down the structures completely and give the food to families that really need them. I'm going to ask you later, after you're done reading the book, if this gives you any ideas as to how you might be able to help people with a contest of your own. Make sure you go all the way to the end of the lesson. Tune in to see my YouTube challenge video, and then come to tutoring today to see the new puppy. And as always, email me if you have any questions at all, scholars. Crush it today. You can do it. Bye.